men are taking classes to unlearn masculinity after Weinstein scandal grows. The scandal of accused serial sexual abuser Harvey Weinstein has raised awareness regarding the abuse of women in the workplace, and that is a good thing. However, the Weinstein scandal has also provided an avenue for liberals attack masculinity, which isn't such good thing because it leads them to assume all forms of masculinity are bad. The term toxic masculinity has gained steam over the past couple of years, and it suggests that masculinity is bad for men. Weinstein's exploits will no doubt add fodder to the liberal cause of feminizing men. Already, the left has come up with a way to counter the evils associated with toxic masculinity. For example, men can attend classes to help them combat their manliness. Rethink Masculinity, a partnership between Collective Action for Safe Spaces, Rethink and DC Rape Crisis Center, is a men's consciousness-building group in which people identifying as men collectively learn how social constructs of masculinity harm themselves and the people around them. As the name suggests, these types of classes involve unlearning the masculinity that supposedly drives men to behave badly. Eric Minkowski, associate chair of the psychology department at Portland State University, teaches a course titled Psychology of Men and Masculinities which, he says, deconstructs how masculinity is socialized as a performative mask rather than a biological imperative, according to the cut. It seems like that way of thinking is backward, but that shouldn't be too surprising coming from a bunch of liberals. These kinds of classes are dangerous because they attempt to undo something that isn't bad. Despite what the left would have us believe, men and women are different. God made men stronger and more powerful than women so they can, among other things, defend their families and provide for them. Moreover, masculinity is not toxic. While liberals push to destroy the image of men being strong and powerful, they are moving to effectively emasculate them. Doing so would help the left tear down values conservatives that believe in, and nothing would make them happier. Worst of all, though, is that the effort confuses, probably deliberately, the kind of behavior Weinstein is accused of with what it means to be a man. The problem of sexual abuse and violence against women can, and should, be tackled without stripping men of the characteristics that God gave them. Please like and share this story on Facebook and Twitter to spread the word about how liberals are trying to destroy manliness.